The question now, where is the boyfriend, Brian Laundrie? Well, he was last seen earlier this week at his Florida home when he was named a person of interest, but now has vanished. News specialist Matt Rascone looks at the latest on the search for Laundrie.
Day two of the search for Brian Laundrie wrapped up just before 6, and police said nothing new to report at the wildlife reserve in Florida, not far from his home. Here's how he got here. Laundrie showed up at his home in Northport on September 1st after traveling for a couple of months with Gabby Petito across the country. He arrived with her van, but without her. She was reporting missing 10 days later, and Brian was named a person of interest in the disappearance. But since then, neither he nor his family would talk to police until Friday. That's when the family requested police come to their home. The assumption was the family was finally talking about Gabby. Instead, we learned the visit had everything to do with Brian's disappearance. Police said his parents were on the phone with their attorney while police were going through the home. And according to the family, Brian was last seen Tuesday when he packed a backpack and told his family he was going to an environmental park. He drove there in a Mustang. The Laundrie family said they picked up that vehicle on Tuesday from the park. On Saturday, investigators began searching the Carlton Reserve, a massive park that covers 24,000 acres. Dozens of police officers joined with FBI agents, drones, and canines in that search. It was the parents that led investigators to that location. From the beginning, police have called this a missing persons case, not a crime. No word on how this tragic news out of Wyoming changes their approach. Police said tonight they were saddened and heartbroken to learn Gabby had been found dead. They said their focus has been to bring her home from day one, and they'll continue to work with the FBI in the search for more answers.